you've gone through a lot of running since then and different strength training, those kind of things. So it's time just to see where you are now, if anything's changing. See if we get that asymmetry back to symmetry.
I'll tell you right now that the asymmetry is gonna still be there.
We'll test everything with forces, body positioning, vertical oscillation, everything you get from a lot of the wearables in a very accurate way. And we'll find out left, right sides, if there's any asymmetries going on. If you're moving this way at 7 minute pace and you're very symmetrical, sometimes the faster you run, it becomes asymmetrical. So we're gonna do 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4 minute pace today and see how Clayton's form looks.
So something that's interesting about this test is they have you do the test in like an A-type shoe, meaning a non-super shoe. And so this is pretty much a racing flat. Very minimal, no super foam, no plate. It takes a lot to process this data and to kind of get a grasp on it. And sometimes as an athlete, it can kind of be daunting. So to have a team around me with Stryd and with Doc and his biomechanics lab is super helpful. And so what we'll do is we'll take some main key takeaways from this study as well as what we're seeing in my data and apply it in the weight room and my plyos and in my training. So that way I can be a faster, more efficient runner. I'm powerful. We know I'm powerful. We just got to get that power moving me forward.